G'day and welcome to Greenfingers. I'm very happy to say and a little bit proud that our sustainability classroom has been a massive hit. We've already taken it into 3 primary schools here in the Perth metropolitan area, and today we're at Bannister Creek Primary School and we will finish off number 4. There's a lot to do though. The aquaponics needs to go in, the urban orchard needs to be planted out, and we have rather a large bit of water-wise lawn that needs to be laid out perfectly. We might need your help. Stick with us and let's enjoy today's version of Greenfingers.
Keeping chickens are a wonderful way of introducing a little bit of nature into the backyard. They really do make the perfect low-maintenance pet. And fancy being able to recycle your food scraps into fresh organic eggs. Tod,
yes,
kids,
mate.
How gorgeous are these little chickens? These particular varieties are heritage varieties, so they're a lot tougher than some of the other sort of commercial varieties that are out there. So we've got Polish Akanas, Frizzlers, and the lovely little New Hampshire.
And they're all cute.
They are particularly cute.
When I pet, she feels soft.
They will go on laying eggs for up to 10 years. So they really do make that sort of lovely pet to have in the backyard and to grow up with the kids. And there's nothing more fun than going out and collecting fresh eggs each morning in your own backyard. When we bring our chickens home, we want to make sure that we're bringing them to a nice, safe home. It's important that we use a fairly heavy-duty mesh, and ideally one that extends down into the ground. We want to make sure that there's no chance of dogs or foxes getting into the cage. Then they'll have a happy life and be around for years to come. If they come home as either day-olds or 2 to 3 week-old birds, we need to start them off on a diet of chicken crumbles, and that will continue for the first 6 to 8 weeks. Then they can go on to natural grains and our lovely food scraps. And before you know it, you'll have your own fresh eggs.
I think it's cute.
Say bye, Barbara. Hi, Barbara. Bye. There you go, Barbara. They can fly, but not very far. Now, there's a chicken outside. We've got to catch the chicken.
The natural fall on this site is absolutely ideal for the creation of this mini amphitheater. It's a classroom component of the sustainability classroom. This is where the kids will sit and listen to the teachers talk about what's going on in their garden. And the ideal surface for the kids to sit on is turf, but not just any old turf. We're using village green. It's a super hardy, low maintenance form of kikuyu, which we know will perform brilliantly all year. But it's really important not just to lay it on any old sand. We've gone to a lot of effort to prepare the soil here. We've incorporated soil solver into the subsoil and then put a layer of this special lawn mix from Soils Ain't Soils. This will make sure the turf establishes really quickly and continues to thrive for years to come. Stay tuned later in the program and we'll show you just how tough this turf is on a grand scale and also in an average suburban garden.
Okay, so we're getting warmed up here for the big job ahead of us, Daz.
How exactly is this helping, Toddy?
This is helping, but I reckon we should stop these guys.
Leave the wheelbarrow there.
Leave the barrow, Benno. Exercise.
Exercise, Ben.
Doesn't he look happy about that?
These guys are an absolute full bottle when it comes to planting trees. Katia, don't you go anywhere. Katia, when you plant the tree in the ground, do you prepare the soil?
No, we prepare the soil and then put the plant in.
Oh, you're excellent too. What's your favourite fruit there, Abby?
Apple, because an apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Does too. And Taranjo, what's your favourite fruit?
Mango, because it's really sweet.
I love mangoes as well. Just wondering, Isabella, do you think every garden, everyone should have a fruit tree in their back garden?
Yes, because...
Because, I know why, because they're healthy and you can also save money. And I've had enough of this exercise and I'm out of here, run!
Throughout this season of Greenfingers, we've been showing you these amazing systems and they really are very easy to set up. A hydroponics tray, expanded clay, a pump, a tank, and within a few short days, you're growing your own range of edible plants and a fantastic selection of fish. The other great thing is they're easy to manage. So, Maurice, we're going to be using the expanded clay to plant into. It really is our best option, isn't it?
Yes, Steve, it is, absolutely. We've looked at other options, but the expanded clay has the greatest capillary properties. It's lightweight, very long-lasting. We've looked at river stone and pea gravel and regular granite stone, and even though they're cheaper options sort of thing, they don't stack up for those capillary properties, getting the microbial action, and also they're about 2 to 3 times heavier than the expanded clay.
This looks like the way to go.
Absolutely, it's a great product.
It's most important that we let the water settle for 24 hours, Maurice.
Yeah, that's very important, Steve. It allows the chlorine to dissipate out the water, and allows the fish to be healthy and satisfied in that water.
Well, in this particular pond we're putting in rainbow trout, one of my favourite. What sort of cost are we looking at with our fish?
Well, fingerling started at roughly $1 a centimetre, so they start from a couple of bucks each. But rainbow trout at this time of year are the most freely available fish for us through the nursery stocks. They will cope with a temperature of about 16 to 18 degrees, while the barramundi are about 26 to 28 degrees. So they're kind of 10 degrees cooler fish.
Fantastic. Now the kids are on a great project here. They've started to plant. They're putting in silver beet, lettuce, strawberries, chives. How's it going there, kids?
Great!
Fantastic. One of the other options, Maurice, is to use these add-on grow channels. Tell us a little bit about these.
Yeah, I believe you saw those down at Murdoch TAFE.
We and did.
These are an 80 by 70 mil hydro channel. They're UV stabilised and they're absolutely perfect for growing lettuce. Check the roots out on that one there, Steve.
Amazing, mate. Absolutely beautiful.
Quite simply, just add that to as part of the plumbing off to the side of your channel, of your tray. That's no problem.
So, great way to extend the system. Fish hides. These look simple and easy to build. Tell us a little bit about those.
Yeah, they're a great DIY thing, Steve. The trout and the yabbies, they love hiding away in there. Keeps them nice and dark and secure.
We've got all our test kits here to make sure the water stays nice and healthy. But I think a really important part of a lot of these systems, Maurice, are the metal frames to go over, just to protect young children from any problems.
Yeah, it's a big safety issue for schools. Obviously, a body of water needs to be covered so that safe for the kids.
Nice, simple, easy way to do it. Black plastic cover over the top. Now, this really helps keeping the algae levels to a bare minimum, and you'd recommend that we put this in place?
Yeah, it's good if you've got a tank that's covered, because you stop the full sun getting into the tank growing a lot of algae, and that, of course, draws down on what the plants can't take up as nitrogen. Okay. So we're trying to reduce down the algae biomass.
OK, so it's just a great way to keep the system lovely and healthy.
Absolutely, yep.
Brilliant. All right, well, it just keeps getting better all the time here. Fantastic system, great way to grow our own fish, grow our own fresh, healthy veggies. Thanks, Maurice.
You're welcome, Steve. Thank you.
Sue, I'm doing a bit of a stock take. Have you seen the aquaponics?
It's looking great, Todd.
The plants look good already. I don't think they're growing, but the fish look pretty happy. I love it. But while the kids are busy behind us, stock take. What's the pinkerbell? Tell me about that.
Todd, the pinkerbell is a dwarf apple. It's one of the pink lady type apples,
yep.
And it's quite compact growing. It'll only grow to about 2 metres, spread to about 1 metre, doesn't require any pruning, and it'll be easy for the kids to pick.
That's actually good for my garden. I do love the pink lady and the leprechaun. Now, a leprechaun to me is a very small person.
Yes, well, this is a little apple tree as well. It's a Granny Smith type apple
yep.
tree. It's also a compact form, and it grows a lot like the pinkerbell does, so they should be great. They'll cross-pollinate each other.
Cross-pollination, does that mean they work together?
Yes, sure. That means you'll get lots of apples when the bees cross-pollinate them.
Good. So pinkerbell is good, leprechaun is good. Super dwarf nectarine, what is that?
Super dwarf nectarine, there's a few of these on the market, but we're planting sunset.
Yep.
This one's got a beautiful red leaf, which it carries throughout the year.
Oh, that's true.
And it's got full-sized yellow flesh nectarines. It'll only grow to about 1.5 metres. Very compact, so it's great for pots, balconies, that sort of space as well.
Excellent. And all of these would be good in your garden, my garden, or your garden?
Absolutely, Todd.
So if you don't have a Sue to help you with your knowledge and wisdom about plants, PlantNet website is the best place to go. Do you think I need help?
You do, Todd.
Thanks. Hey, Connor, what's so good about a lawn?
Keeps the house cool.
Very cool. Any ideas, Cameron?
Well, you can play sports on it.
Yeah, that's good too. Harry, what about you? Do you play sport?
Yep.
What's your favourite sport?
Soccer.
Any good?
Yeah.
Yes, he is. He's good. And Madison, lawns. Do we use a lot of water on lawns?
Not if they're waterwise.
That's quite true. Coming up after the break, this lawn on a massive scale, and we'll do some veggie planting.
Daz, why are the kids putting your lunch in the worm farm?
It's not my lunch.
All right, it's not your lunch. Are you helping them?
No, they don't need any help. They know exactly what they're doing and they're 100% in control.
I love it. And speaking of in control, the Masters team have done a great job with the pavers and supplied all the wood. Let me see. The chooks are in, the aquaponics is in, fruit trees have been supplied, and you've been laying some lawn.
Not only have I been laying lawn here, I've been down in suburban Canningvale laying lawn, and I went down to Meadow Springs to Quarry Park and had a look at village green there. Talking like acres of it. It's amazing. You have to see it.
Can we have a look at that right now?
Why don't we have a look at it right now? Many of the products and ideas we use in domestic landscaping have previously been tested and developed in large-scale commercial and council projects such as parks, schools and council buildings. And a classic example of this is this turf, village green. This is a newly developed form of the well-known Kaikuya turf with all the positive attributes of its almost indestructible parent, but none of the negatives. It's more compact, a neater grower, and rarely produces seeds. The soft, fine leaf foliage is perfect for a wide range of applications, according to Kim Lawrence, Mervac's development director, who oversaw the construction of Quarry Park here in Meadow Springs.
We looked at some of the hybrid couch varieties, but ultimately went with village green, because it retains its green all year round. It's drought tolerant. It only needs to be watered twice a week. It's disease free, so a fantastic grass that deals with high foot traffic and constant shade from the trees.
We're taking the lessons we learnt at Quarry Park and are applying them to this suburban garden in Canningvale. Now the existing lawn was pretty terrible, a worn out mix of weeds and wild couch. So Jason and I ripped it out and put it where it belongs, in the bin guy's bin. We've put down a layer of quality lawn underlay and it's time to roll out the village green. Village green will develop a massive deep root system and this is the key to its durability and resilience. So even with restricted watering and fertilising, this lawn will stand up to a harsh Perth climate, constant wear and tear and a large amount of neglect. The foliage cover on village green is really dense and it stays that way and this helps to keep weeds at bay. And if you've got kids and pets running around on it, you won't see those quickly developing bare patches so evident on other types of lawn. And this combined with the soft fine foliage makes village green the ideal family friendly lawn. Landscapers are quickly learning to love this turf. It keeps its colour all year and continues to grow through winter, so it can be successfully established at any time of the year. And if the unlikely happens and a section does get damaged, they know it has the quickest recovery rate of any turf variety. What a difference from a scraggly, weed-infested mess that was using large amounts of water and fertiliser to a front yard showpiece that will look this good for years to come with minimal maintenance. Village Green is set to be the turf of choice for Perth gardens. Now I better get back to Bannister Creek Primary and help Sue plant some veggies. All the veggie beds are in and we've filled them up with this super rich garden art soil compost. Now Sue, you've put all the veggies out for me. What are we planting today?
Well Daz, we've got lots of winter varieties going in. We've got cabbage, cauliflower, broccoli, peas, all the brassicas, that sort of thing. And we've got these Asian veg, which are nice and quick growing, so the kids should be able to harvest these in a couple of weeks.
Excellent. And I see by the fairy sign on the label there, these are banana seedlings.
They are. They're lovely and healthy, and you should be able to get these from any good garden centre.
Excellent. Now, we know banana have been around a long time, but do you know how long they've been around?
I don't actually, Daz.
50 years next year.
Wow.
So when we've got these all in, I believe you're going to teach the kids a little bit about crop rotation. Why is crop rotation so important?
Well, Daz, if you plant the same thing, the same variety in the soil in the same place each time, you might get disease build up, so we want to avoid that.
Oh, definitely. And once we've got all these in today, we'll mulch all the veggie beds with Garden Art Fine Earth Blanket. That'll keep the soil nice and cool through summer, and as it breaks down, it'll help feed the soil ready for the next crop. Well, Sue, I don't think we better sit around here talking about it. We better do it.
There's
Let's get into it.
Lots to do. Come on, kids.
If you're planting a veggie patch at home, be it aquaponics or any veggie patch, there's a couple of rules to consider. You've got to put it in the right position, don't you, Josie?
Yeah, you have to put it in sun so it would help it grow.
And also shelter, Georgina. Is that important?
Yeah, that's to protect it from the hot easterly winds.
Quite true. What about the dirt itself, Job?
Well, you need to put fertiliser in it and water it on a daily basis.
Yes, you do. And in summer, it's important to just whack it down, isn't it?
But, Todd, in summer, you have to plant the plants further away from each other.
Caden, that's true. So they get a better chance of water.
Excellent stuff. These guys are experts. Coming up after the break, we're going to give you some mulching like you've never seen before and a few barbecue tips.
Toddy, come here.
Yes, mate. How can I help you?
I've heard a rumour that you now think that you are an expert in planting fruit trees.
I'm an expert at planting fruit trees?
Well, then how come you forgot something?
I didn't forget anything, mate.
You did forget something.
No, I did not. Oh, the mulch.
The mulch.
Oh, okay.
We need to put down a 100mm layer of mulch around every fruit tree.
By jingo, mate, that's a lot of mulch.
Well, by jingo, I've got a dingo from the hire guys.
I thought mulch was just there to look good.
Mate, by accident, you're almost right again, because now there is a decorative option.
Wow.
Take a look at this.
There was a time when you could have your mulch in any colour you wanted, as long as that colour was a sort of muddy brown. But that's all about to change with the release of Recycle Art coloured mulch in two eye-catching fashion colours. The garden beds in this front yard are looking more than a little drab and certainly don't complement this fantastic new lawn. So we're going to jazz it up with this great new product from BioWise. There's the Midnight Black and Jason's favourite, the Lipstick Red. Thanks, Jace. This mulch is made from recycled, shredded wood waste, material that would otherwise end up in landfill. And the pigments used are perfectly safe for your garden. In fact, they're food grade, the red being iron oxide and the black is carbon, so they will naturally break down into the soil. The colour is retained for about 18 months to 2 years, and when the colour starts to fade, simply top it up to regain that fresh,